Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, The ENT Resident. Today I'll be discussing another small Viva question that you get asked when you get a case of aticoantral disease. And that is, what is the SAIT classification for pars tensa retraction? You can also purchase my notes now. I've added the links in the description. Okay, so let's get started. First, let's look at what a normal tympanic membrane looks like and how will you draw a schematic diagram of it to represent it if you had to do it in your exams. So this is the EAC over here. This is where the normal tympanic membrane is placed. This is the incus over here, the stapes, and this is the middle ear. This is how it normally you can represent schematically. And you can see in the left-sided image over here, this is how a normal tympanic membrane looks like. This is the left-sided tympanic membrane. And you can see that there is the light reflex in the anteroinferior quadrant. Now, let's talk about grade 1 of SAIT's classification. What happens in grade 1 is the tympanic membrane is very minimally retracted and it does not contact incus or any middle ear structures. And you can see that there is a loss of right light reflex. So you can see over here, the dotted line over here represents the presence of a normal tympanic membrane, whereas this bold line is where the retracted tympanic membrane is. And you can see how it is not at all touching the incus or any middle ear structure. And in the endoscopic picture over here, you can see that there has been a loss of light reflex. So this is what grade 1 is. Next, moving on to grade 2, the retracted tympanic membrane here starts to touch either the long process of incus or the stapes. So you see in the schematic diagram, this is the normal tympanic membrane, the dotted lines. This is the retracted tympanic membrane and here it is touching the long process of incus. And this is what an endoscopic picture looks like. You can see that the long process is very prominent. Next, moving on to grade 3. Grade 3 is also known as middle ear atelectasis. And here what happens is the retracted tympanic membrane is in contact with the promontory. However, the difference with grade 4 here is that it will move on cicalization. If you try to do Valsalva maneuver or suctioning or any kind of movement, you'll see that the air pressure inside the ear, you'll see that it will be moving. So that is what middle ear atelectasis is. And in the image here, you can see that this is the promontory and that's where the tympanic membrane is adherent to. Last is grade 4. Now you'll see that the image drawn over here for the schematic diagram for grade 3 and grade 4 are the same. The only difference between both of them is whether they'll move on cicalization or not. Grade 3 will definitely move on cicalization, whereas grade 4 will not. So what is grade 4? Grade 4 is also known as adhesive otitis media. Here, the tympanic membrane gets plastered to the promontory and it does not move on cicalization. You can see in the otoendoscopic image over here how it is the tympanic membrane is completely plastered to the promontory. So that's all for today. I'll see you in my next class.